was 4 hours to go. I was actually 4 shots in front. But Arnold, I three-putted 15, and Arnold birdied, so that made 2. And at St Andrews, you can see what's happening to the players ahead, you know. And then he made 4 at the 16th, and I made my 4. And then I saw him get 4 off the road at the 18th, at the 17th. And I put my second shot on the green, but I didn't want to go over on the road, but on the green, but short. I had a long putt, so I putted down about 6 foot short, I guess. And Arnold was on the 18th, and he had about a 12-footer for birdie, and I thought I'd wait and see what happened, you know, so, and he holed it. So it meant that if I didn't make this 6-footer for my 4, I had to birdie the last to win, but I never looked like it never looked like missing. I put a good stroke on, and up the 18th, and I pitched to about 3.5 feet. I missed the one that ripped around, and then I just turned and knocked it in. And I could hear Henry Longhurst saying, "Oh, be careful, be careful." But you know, that was it. Just how it worked out. It was like a no one had any money on me. Pete, he was going to put £5 on, but he didn't. So we had celebration at the presentation. Pete loaned me his jacket. This crowd was a big crowd around it. I wouldn't be able to get backwards and forwards, you know. So I won the Open and took the cup in Pete's jacket. I birdied 16, and it turned around and Gary had to make 4 at the last to tie, and he did. We both hit good putts. I left mine about 1/2 inch short of the hole, and he left his about three inches short. And then it was a playoff. Playoff next day. I three putted the first hole. And that gave Gary a one-stroke lead. And then he held about a 40-footer at the second, and I held a 20-footer on top of it. And when we got to the third, he held another 40-footer, and I couldn't match him there. And then I got one back at the fourth, and then I hooked the dog leg left, and I hooked it a little bit more to the left than I wanted. And I saw the ball go up in the air about 20 feet. I hit a woman on the head. Well, there's all the ladies lying down here about 8 feet away from my ball, and she still hadn't come out of it. And she got blood all through her hair. And I'm in this couch grass about so many inches deep. I sort of took a 6-iron out of it to get out, and didn't hang on enough with the left hand, and hit a lady on the leg. So I got 2 ladies on the same hole, made a double bogey. And that's just sort of our finish. Gary had 71, I had 74. But that was a bit of a disappointment. He wasn't a particularly good driver, but he's strong. And he got up and down a lot, you know, like from places that I still see where he was, and he'd say, well, he made par or birdie. He'd say, oh, there's no way, but Arnold manufactured it somewhere or other. But no, he was good to play with. He just go about his business. Pretty hard to play with him in America. The people were Arnie's army, and they all had a bit of trouble with the because in the early days they didn't fence off the rope off the walls, the fairway. So had a lot of trouble moving the people and that sort of stuff. It used to get you down a bit. But he was good to play with, really. I can remember one hole that was a par three across a bit of a ravine, and you went into a bunker. There was a bunker in front and there was a bunker behind, and the pin was in the middle of that. And I hit a good shot and went just one over in the back part of the bunker, and trying to be a bit careful, I went underneath it and just set it up on the bank. And there was nowhere to stand right-handed. So I had a bullseye, which was a double face. And I'd often practice a little bit left-handed. You know, so I just turned around left-handed and had a couple of bit of and knocked in about a 16 footer. Hogan just dropped his club on the ground and he looked up at the sky, and the crowd went wild, you know. Anyway, when a little while after we came in, Ben didn't say anything, but a little while after we came in, Jackie Burke came up to me. And he said, geez, Kel, he says, what have you done to Hogan? I said, I haven't done anything to Hogan. He said, well, Hogan's down there with a group of reporters around him. And he said, he doesn't do it with his right, he does it with his left. Yeah, I loved to watch Samson. He had a big, full, slow, lovely rhythm. He really was. He was good. He was long in those days. So I don't know what he'd do today with the big-headed driver and the ball the way it goes. But he was legendary, the Sammy, Slammy Sam, they called him.